जस्ट अ मिनट। Okay, so here it will take the year and it will check whether the year is a leap year or not. Do we know what is leap year?
Leap year? No.
How many days in a year?
365.
Okay. And in this year, how many days are there? How many days in February? How many days is in February month?
How many days in February month?
In normally in
28
normally. But see that in this year it is having 29. Means 2020 is a leap year. Means we have 366 days. So leap year means the year which contain 366 days, then that is called as the leap year. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
So those are the year contain 366 days, that is called as the leap year. Then to find out the leap year, we are check for this condition. Okay, some year means normally when the year is divisible by 4, then that is called as the leap year. Okay, so that we thought that when a year is divisible by 4, it is called as a leap year. But some of the year are present, those are divisible by 4, but it is not leap year. So for checking the leap year, we have some kind of condition. What is that? See here. We are having multiple condition. To check with multiple condition, we are using else if part. See that. First, it is asking you enter a year. Okay, so it is asking you enter a year. The user is giving a year. Then we accept it and store in the year variable. The year modulo 400 is equals to 0. So the year that you have passed, it is modulo 400 is equals to 0. If it is S, then it is saying you it is a leap year. Okay. And if the year that you have passed, it is not divisible by 400, then again it is going to the another condition. Is your year divisible by 100 is equals to 0? Year modulo 100 is equals to 0, then it is not considered as it is a leap year. So it is not showing you it is a leap year. Then if that condition is again false, then it is going to this part. Year modulo 4 is equals to 0. Okay, so year modulo means you divide this year 2020 divided by 4. If your remainder is 0, then it is showing you it is a leap year. Now check here.
Mm-hmm.
Enter a year. Suppose I pass here 2020. It is showing you it is a leap year. Then again, I suppose I pass 21, so it is not a leap year. It is having 365 days. So those are the year contain 365 days. Then it is called as it is not a leap year. Just a minute. Copy it. Okay, it is a leap year program. I have stored it. Next. I will show some exercise, just a minute. Bin or odd, already we discussed. Then, C program can return over that visual forecasting board. Okay, can you do this? Write a C program to find the largest of three numbers. You have to take the three numbers as input and find out which one is the largest. Can you do it? Three?
I'm not sure. Maybe.
So you try it. Okay, you try it. I will help you. Okay. First, you take the three number, then accept it, then I will tell you what to do. Share your screen.
Okay, sure. I want to set them up. Yeah.
Then for accepting the three number, you write. You write a program, you write enter first number, enter second number, enter third number, and accept it. Just like in the normally we did. Type enter first number. Scanf. First you define the variable, no? The four variable you have to define. Int num1, num2, num3. Then.
So int, I think.
I am giving a text that you have to take the three value and compare. So for the three value, you require the three memory allocation. Got it?
Yes, got it.
So define it, int num1, num2, and num3. This. Yes, semicolon, and another is result.
One second.
Okay, then semicolon, give semicolon, that statement is over now.
Yeah.
Then for accepting the input and store in a variable, what to write?
I'm not sure.
Scanf, we're defining scanf now. Where to write? After printf. After printf. You are giving an instruction to the computer that you have to enter the first number. Then you have to accept the number. Yes. Then for accepting the integer value, what to write? Percentile? Percentile, yes, in bracket you have to mention. Good. In bracket you have to give scanf, then bracket start, and in double quotation you have to pass. Double quotation, yes, good. Then comma. After double quotation. Comma. Percentile. What to write? Percentile. Where you have to store first number? So when the user is giving a first number, in which variable you have to store?
I'm not sure.
How many variable you have defined? How many variable you have defined?
Four.
Yes. Then, then what to write? Percentile. Ampersand. Which one? First number is stored where? The number you have taken, first number that you have taken, that you have to store where?
I'm not sure.
At Tell me which one you want to say, right? Tell me. You have to store in num1 or your num2, your num3 or result. So when user is giving the number, first number, in which location you have to store? Yeah, it is num1 or it is num2 or it is num3 or result. Where you have to store?
I don't understand.
Okay, so see that when a user is giving a value to a computer, then it is what? Suppose I'm giving you some kind of, you can say, do you know kheer prepared by milk and what, your rice? Do you have it? Suppose I want to give you milk, okay? Then when I give you milk, where you have to store? Where you have to take it?
I'm not sure.
When I give you milk, okay, suppose I give you the noodles, okay? Then how you have to take it?
With the hand.
With the?
Hand.
In hand you have to eat. You require what? Yeah.
Four.
You require a bowel?
Yeah.
Yeah, plate you require? Yes or no? Similar way, when the user is giving a fast number, then in which location you have to store? You have to store in num1, yeah, num2, yeah, num3 or result. Where you have to store?
I don't know. Num1.
Yes, num1. try to give answer, then you will find the condition. Good. Percentile, right? Sorry, ampersand, and symbol you write. Remove 4.
Okay.
Remove up to 4. Yes, comma, percentile D, comma. Then give ampersand symbol. Which one is the ampersand and symbol? In 7 number you can get.
I don't know.
And symbol. 7 number key. In your keyboard, where it is written 7, and
I don't wait. So I'm first one right here.
Yes. Then similar way, enter second number and enter third number, right?
Yeah.
Give the semicolon after scanf statement.
Okay.
Then similar way. So we are taking a first number, then you have to store the second number and third number. Right?
Mm-hmm.
Then what to write? We have enter first number, then you have to accept second number and third number in the same manner.
I don't really understand.
This line is used for, this two line, it is used for taking the first number. Similar way, you have to take the second number and third number in the same manner. It is the two line, it is representing you to take the first number. In the same way, you have to take the second and third number, same way. Then you write printf second number, then scanf percentile D num2, similar way third number, right?
Mm-hmm.
In the same manner.
Okay.
Let's enter second number. Good. Semicolon. Be fast.
Okay.
Then for storing the value in the variable, what to write? Here, what we have written for storing a value? We are writing scanf. Similar way, write scanf.
Okay.
What to write now? Num to is similar with for third number, right? The program. Third, RD. Third. Three at D.
Yes.
Complete the sentence. Enter third number. Good. Now, for checking a condition, what to write? Which construct is used for checking a condition? We written in a leap year, for checking a leap year, which thing we are using? We are using if part, if else, yes or no?
Yes.
So similar way, for conditional construct, so when you have some kind of condition, for checking the conditional construct, we're using if and else part. Clear? Which part we are using?
If and else.
If and else. Okay, so now you have to write if statement. Next line.
So, like that.
Just a minute, I'll give you. You just stop your screen share, then I will display you. So here, for checking the condition, we are using a three number, int norm 1, norm 2, and norm 3. So we are taking the input, the three values. So we are taking the three value, and it is display first number, percentile D, second number, then third number. So check here. When I run the program, so it is asking you import the three value. Suppose no. 25, 55. Then it is showing you which number is greater, 25, 55, and 12. In between, which one is the greatest? The second number is greater. Yes or no? Now check. Based upon our input, how the condition are checked. The first, it will check whether your number 1 is greater than number 2. Means 25 is greater than 55. No? Is 25 is greater than 55?
Yes, no.
No, condition is false means up to this part is false. Then it is going to this else part. Number 2 is greater than number 3. 55 is greater than 12.
Yes.
Yes, 55 is greater than 12.
Yes.
Then it is showing you what? The second number is greater. Clear?
Mm-hmm. Yes, clear.
Now, when I run another program, when I run this program, just a minute, 1 minute. Moya dekhao ji. Okay, so next we are passing another three number. Suppose I'm passing here 99, then 12. Then I am passing here 45, three number. Okay, one is 99, 12, another is 45. Now it is showing you the first number is greatest among three. How? Now first it will check, 99 is greater than 12. Mm-hmm. Condition is true. So in the 99 we are stored in the first number, norm 1. The 99 is greater than 12. Condition is true.
Yes.
Then again it has comes to here, 12 is greater than 40, 12 is greater than 45.
Yes, yes.
12 is 99 is greater than 45. Yes.
I'm just getting confused.
Okay, so it is showing you the first number is greater than among the three. Clear?
Yeah.
got this answer? It is clear to you?
Yes, kind of.
You just remember means you are just forgetting how to take the input. Just remember that for taking the input we are using scanf. For taking the what when the user is giving a value, so after taking the value and storing the variable, we're using scanf is used. Clear? The scanf work is taking the input from user and storing the variable. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
Now we go for another program, another value that is checking for third number is greater or not. Suppose we're taking here 25 56 then 78. So now it is showing you third number is greater. Okay, so it is showing you third number is greater. So how? Now first number is 25. The 25 is greater than 56. 25 is yes. Greater. 25 is greater than 56. Then 25 is greater than here it will come. If it is no, then if condition is false, 25 is greater than 56 is false here. It is false. Now 56 is greater than 78. 56 is greater than 78.
No.
Condition is false again. Then it is showing you here the third number is greatest. Clear?
Mm-hmm. Yes, clear.
Then Okay. Now check that in the first number we are passing 78. 78 is greater than 108.
No.
Now this condition is false. Now 108 is greater than number 3. 108 is greater than 23.
Yes.
Then it is showing you second number is greater. Okay. That is the example of storing this number. Okay, so now And now next program is okay, so it is another program. So write a C program to find the eligibility of admission for a professional course based upon the following criteria. The eligibility criteria is the marks in math is greater than 75. Okay, then marks in physics is greater than equals to 55. Marks in chemistry is greater than equals to 50. And the total in three subjects is 190. And total in math and physics is greater than equals to 140. Then the selection criteria will be processed. It is not a good one. I'll go into another part. That's one. Write a C program, read the temperature in centigrade and display the suitable message according to the temperature state below. If temperature is less than zero, then it is showing you freezing weather. If it is 0 to 10, then very cold weather. 10 to 20, then cold, 20 to 30, then normal. 30 to 40 is it is hot, and if it is greater than 40, it is very hot. Can I do this?
Maybe, probably not.
Maybe. Can you try?
I don't know if I can do it.
It is an if-else program. Just like you are taking the three number and check whether it is correct or not. It's just like that. Okay, I will. Connected as your outgoing validity has expired. To continue services. Just a minute. It is a condition that it is has given. So these are the condition you have to give. If your temperature is less than zero, then it is saying you're freezing weather. Then 0 to 10, then very cold weather. 10 to 20 is only cold weather. 20 to 30 is normal weather temperature. 30 to 40 it is hot weather, and if it is greater than equals to 14, it is saying you very hot weather. Now check. Check here, INT temperature, it is showing you input day's temperature. Now when you are printing, if temperature is greater than less than zero, it is showing you it is a freezing weather. You can write it is freezing weather. Then if you are passing here, if temperature is less than 10, then it is showing you it is very cold weather. Then next is, if it is showing you temperature is less than 20, then it is showing you cold weather. Put in the bracket, then it is helping you to understand. Tell me, what is it?
Then, sorry, I'll just continue, please.
Just that if I write here, let me arrange it, then I will explain you. Thank you. now we run the file. Input days in temperature. Suppose I'm passing here temperature is suppose 49. Then it is showing you it is very hot. Now check how the flow will continue. It is showing you input days in temperature. The web I'm passing here 49. The 49 is insert where? It is stored in the TMP variable. Now the condition has check here. 49 is greater than 0. 49 is less than 0. Condition is false. 49 is not less than 0. Then it is coming to this part. Yes or no?
Yes. Yeah.
Then 49 is less than 10. No, 49 is not less than 10. Yes, tell me.
Yeah, no.
Okay. Then now 49 is less than 20.
Forty-nine is not less than 30.
Okay. Now 49 is less than 30.
No.
Okay. Then 49 is less than 40. Okay. Then 49 is not less than 40. Then if that condition is false, then it comes to where? This part. So it is showing you it is very hot. Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I will store this file, the question which is helping you. Then see that. That is when you write the program in C to calculate print the electricity bill of a given customer. So you have to print the electricity bill when the electricity unit is off to 199, then your charge per unit is 1.20. So up to 199, electricity charge is 1.20. 200 and above 400 is 1.50. And 400 and but less than 600 is 1.80. 600 above is it is charge unit is 2. Okay. So if the bill exceed 400, then surcharge 15% will be charged. Okay. So if your bill is exceed to 400 to above, then surcharge 15% is added, and minimum bill should be of 100. Okay, so these are the scenario is present. Another technical question is there. Here I print the next program. The question and solution is what? We go for the solution. Showing the proper output. Just a minute. See that, what is the output of this one? See that. So first of all, it is asking for you customer ID, means electricity bill is required, your consumer ID. Then input the name of the customer, input the unit that you consumed. Okay, so when the unit you are consumed, suppose you consume up to 150, that is counting that the consume electricity is 150, the 150 is less than 200, then your charging amount equals to 1.20. Okay, and if the consumed electricity that you are using 250, so if it is consumed electricity is 250, it is in the range of 200 and 400, the consumed electric charge is 1.50. Then similar way, if your consumed electricity is 400 and less than 600, then charging amount is 1.80. Then your if the charging amount is more than 600, then per unit charge is 2 rupees. Then total amount is consumed electricity, suppose you are taken which value, then charging value. Okay, and if the total bill is greater than 300, then surcharge you have to pass. Surcharge, how you have to calculate, and it is a 15%, then total amount into 15 divided by 100. Okay. So after storing the information, then it is showing you electricity bill number, then customer ID number, customer name, then unit consume, amount charges. I run the file. So you input customer ID, then input customer ID, then customer name. Just a minute. Ampersand. Okay. Our customer name is Sri. Then input the unit consumed. Suppose you are consumed 700. So when you pass 700, then it is showing you here. Customer ID number 205, customer name is Sri, unit consumed is 700. The 700, then it's saying here, if your consumed unit is not less than 600, then if it is more than, then your surcharge will is what? The surcharge is 2 rupees. Okay, so 700 into 2 is what? It is having 1400. Then surcharge amount, how it is calculated? Now it is 15% of the surcharge. So your surcharge amount is 210. Then total electricity it is generated. This one. Clear? So if you are passing less than 700, suppose it is asking you enter customer ID, suppose 990, input customer name, again I have given here 3, then consume electricity, suppose I'm passing here 100. See there, electricity bill, customer ID number is 990, customer name is 3, unit is 100, then total charges is 100 into 1.20, that is 120 rupees. So if it is less than 2, what? If consumer electricity is less than 200, then surcharge equals to 1.20. Then here condition is given. If the net amount is less than 100, then net amount is 100. That another condition we have given. If your net amount is, and if your what the amount is less than unit is less than 100, then there is no surcharge will have to pass. Okay. The next program is another program. Like when you pass the grade, if you pass any character, if it is E, then it is showing you excellent. If it is B, very good. If it is G for good. If it is A for average. If it is A for fail. So if you pass any character, it is A, B, then it is showing you that character. Okay. If it is A, then if it is, when you pass E, then it is showing you excellent. When you pass B, is very good. When you pass G, it is good. When you pass A, it is average. When you pass F, then it is showing you fail. That is another part we are passing. Can you do it? This one, Sri.
Hello? Yes.
Can you do it?
No.
If you pass E, then it is showing you excellent. When you pass F, it is showing you fail. Possible for you?
No, I cannot do it.
Okay.
It's hard.
Tell me.
It will be very hard.
It seems very hard.
Yes.
It's just like that you have to pass any character. Then it is find out that the number is. Okay, so it is in another part. I will show you next switch case. Write a C program to read any number and integer and display. Next, we move to the switch case part. So, if else is over, now we move to the switch case. Then comes to the switch case statement. A switch statement allows the variable to be tested equality against the list of value. It's just like that. You are going to the restaurant and you are asking some kind of food or some kind of meal. And if that item or meal is not available, then the waiter is saying you that today these items are not available and this is a special dishes for today, so you have it. The switch case is just like that you have to take the value from user. So you have to get a value from user and check with the multiple value. So that multiple value is mentioned in case statement. So you take the value from user and check with multiple case statement. The case statement is given here, case then your value, case, then your value. So the value that you have taken, if it is matched with any case statement, then the statement inside the case block is executed. Then your break statement is appear. Okay, so if there is no break, then the condition is for checking and it is going to the next part. And if your value is not matched with any case statement, so there is a default statement is present, which is showing you the default value if your condition has not matched. So a switch statement allow the variable to be tested for equality against the list of value. Each value is called as the case and the variable being switched on it. It checked by the each switch case statement. So now, is it understood? Case statement, what is it?
Yeah.
And now, the following rules apply to the switch statement. So what are the rules are available? The expression used in the switch statement must have an integer part, like the value that you have taken and to check whether your value is correct or not, so it will mention in the switch statement. So in the switch statement, you have to mention the value that you want to check. Then you have any number of case statement within the switch. So within the switch, you have any number of case statement. Any number of case statement you have to pass within the switch. Each case is followed by the value to be compared and a colon. The constant expression for case must be same data type. So when you are defining a switch, so your switch statement is like that. I will show you. Suppose here we define switch. Switch, then your variable name. Suppose if you take here int a equals to 6, then int ch equals to 6. Then if you mention here ch, then switch ch, then we pass the value here. Then you mention here case. So if you are defining the integer value here, so here I define int means integer value, then your case will also contain the integer value. The case, so you have to give an option. Suppose if it is 100, then it is printing you printf century. The case statement means the value that we have taken here in a switch statement and we are passing an integer value here. Then the value, if the value is matched, then it is showing you printf century. then here we use break, means if your option has matched, then there is no need to go to the second step. In the case 200, then it is on you. Twin tap double century. Then break. Then if your value is not matched with any case statement, so I am passing for the two option. If your value is not matched with any case statement, then the default statement is executed. In a default, it is showing you printf invalid entry. It is showing you invalid entry. Means we are passing here integer what? Integer 100. The 100 is matched. When 100 is matched, it is showing you century here. It is printing you that part. But if I passing here, int ch is 100. If I passing here, like 500. So 500. Ch 100, no. Ch 200, no. So your condition is false in two cases. Then in default case, it is showing you it is an invalid entry. Understood?
No.
Okay, so let me explain again. Here we pass some option. Option means, suppose I want the item 500. Okay, suppose 500 is one item, but the restaurant is having the item 100 and 200. The restaurant contains 100 and 200, but I want 500. Okay. So when I pass 500, I want 500, then I will check in the menu option. So I'll check in the menu option. So in the fast menu, the value that I am asking, I am looking for, it is equals to the this part. No. It is equal to the this part. No. Then in default, it is showing you that you are not passing the correct item. But if I pass here 200 in place of 500, if I pass here 200, then you check here. Case is 100. No, case is not 100. Then case is 200. Then the value that I have passed here, it is matched with this value. Okay, with the case value, then it is showing you double century. So after showing the double century, there is no need to go to the default statement. So it is display here double century because I found my item and that item is delivered. Clear now?
Yes.
So it is called as the switch case statement, where you want to check the one option with the one value with the multiple option. If it is matched with any option, then the statement is executed. Clear?
What should we do now?
We conclude. We end. What are you asking?
What should we do now?
Yes. Okay. Okay. So, yes, in the next class, I will explain about the rules. Okay. What are the rules are there?
Okay, sure.
बाय बाय।
बाय बाय।